हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस एंड आई विल कवर दिस थ्री पॉइंट्स. फर्स्ट, बेसिक्स ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस. सेकंड, एग्जांपल्स ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस. एंड थर्ड इज द यूज ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस इन डे टू डे लाइफ. सो थर्ड वन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट? सो वी स्टार्ट विद द बेसिक्स. नाउ बिफोर गोइंग टू द इक्वेशंस, वी मस्ट नो अबाउट द एक्सप्रेशंस. सो यू हैव सीन एक्सप्रेशंस लाइक दिस, x प्लस टू sometimes x square plus 2x minus 8. So these are called expressions. Expressions means the collection of terms. Okay. And the equations is nothing but when we equate two expressions, we get, when we equate two expressions, we get the equation. For example, if I'll use equal sign and on left hand side, I write x plus 2, this one, and on right hand side, I write the second one. Now this is called equation. So it is x plus 2 equals to x square plus 2x minus 8. Now this is the equation. Okay. And if we collect all the terms on the left hand side, then there will be 0 on the right hand side, because by transposing all the terms to the left hand side, there is nothing on the right hand side. So we can write 0. Again, we have equal sign. So in equation, we have an equal sign and two sides, LHS and RHS. Okay. LHS means left hand side and RHS means right hand side. So this is an example of equation, right? But our topic is quadratic equation. So what is the quadratic equation actually? As there are different types of equations like linear, quadratic, cubic and biquadratic. So I start with linear and then I'll tell you what is the difference between linear and quadratic equation. So first is linear equation. As x plus 2 equals 7, suppose it is x plus 2 equals to 7, and if we convert this into the equation standard form, okay, the standard form of the equation will be by transposing 7 to the left hand side, and it is just x minus 5 equals 0. Here you can see that the highest power of x is 1, okay, because x can be considered as x power 1. It also can be written as x power 1 minus 5 equals 0. So it is called a linear equation, means the highest power of x is 1. But in the quadratic equation, the highest power of x is 2. For example, it is quadratic equation and we can write 2x square plus 8x minus 3 equals 0, right? So the highest power of the x is 2. That's why it is called quadratic equation. Okay. The highest power is 2 means there are the lower powers. So after 2 we have 1, and with the third term we have x power 0. So it can also be written as 2x square plus 8x power 1 minus 3 multiplied by x power 0 is equal to 0, because the value of x power 0 is always 1. So it is just 3 1 ja 3. But if you want to see the powers of x in every term, we have in this term the power is 2, in this term the power is 1, and in this term the power is 0. So we have three different powers of x, 2, 1 and 0. As you can see, the highest power is 2, so it is called a quadratic equation, right? But we start with the standard form. Okay, then we will discuss different types of quadratic equations. Okay, so the general form of quadratic equation, general form, or we can say standard form. So both the terms are synonyms. Okay, you can say general form or standard form. The general form is ax square plus bx plus c equals 0. Do not forget to write equal sign. Okay, equal 0. Here a, b and c, all these are the letters of the alphabet and these are constants. Okay, sometimes we can say coefficients, right? And the nature of these constants are real numbers. So you know about real numbers. Real numbers are the collection of all rational, okay, rational and irrational numbers. So all rational and irrational numbers taken together are called real numbers. It means we have integers, fractions, decimals and irrational numbers all are constants and these are in the category of real numbers. Now you can see that the highest power of x is 2, that is in the first term, that is ax square. Okay, now we can consider different values of a, b and c and get different quadratic equations. So there are infinite possibilities, means there are infinite values of a, b and c. Suppose if a is equal to 2, okay, b equals 3 and c equals 4, so what will be our quadratic equation? That will be particular form of quadratic equation. Suppose this is the standard form. If we substitute these values, we get 2x square plus 3x plus 4 equals 0. Okay, and if we consider a is minus 2, b is root 3 and c is minus 4 upon 7, doesn't matter, we just need to put these values in the standard form. So it is ax square, so a x square plus b, that is root 3, okay, bx plus c, plus c, again don't forget to write 0, equals 0. After simplifying this, we get minus 2x square plus root 3x minus 4 by 7 equals 0. This is also a quadratic equation. So I hope you understood the concept. Now there is a very important concept, that the maximum number of terms in a quadratic equation. So this is one of the important point, maximum number of terms in a quadratic equation is 3. So why it is 3? As I've written ax square plus bx plus c equals 0, you can see that there are maximum terms which are 3, because we cannot go beyond the x square because it is the highest power. We cannot write x cube or anything else. It means if we skip c, that is the last term, we have ax square plus bx equals 0. It is again a quadratic equation. Okay, the existence of c or non-existence of c will not affect, because the highest power of x is again 2. We can also write ax square plus c equals 0, again quadratic equation, because highest power is 2. Okay, and it is also a quadratic equation because highest power is again 2. So doesn't matter if the remaining terms are there or not, but this term should exist. Okay, ax square, and this term is called the leading term. So this is again another important point, leading term is ax square, because the degree of this term is 2, that's why we call it quadratic equation. So this term should exist in the equation, and the leading coefficient is a. Leading coefficient is a, and what is the coefficient? Simply it is the multiplying factor of the variable, because a is multiplied by x square, so it is the coefficient of x square, right? Now I'm going to give you some examples which may be quadratic or not. So here first example is, if I write x into x square plus 2 minus 7 equals 0, so is it quadratic or not? If you see the bracket, it has the expression x square plus 2, and you might be thinking that yes, it is x square, it is a quadratic equation. Okay, but it is not. So when we simplify this, we get x cube plus 2x minus 7 equals 0. Why x cube? Why we have written x cube? This x is multiplied by this expression inside the bracket, so it is x cube plus 2x minus 7. You can see the highest power is 3, so it is not a quadratic equation, it is just a cubic equation. Okay, second one, if it is x plus 1 x plus 2 equals x square, then is it quadratic or not? So simplify this. On the left hand side, if you multiply both these expressions, we get x square plus 3x plus 2 equals x square. If we have same quantities on both the sides, just cancel out, and we are left with 3x plus 2 equals 0. You can see the highest power of x is 1, so it is not a quadratic equation. Okay, so these are some important examples where you have to decide whether the given equation is quadratic or not. Now next example, suppose we have 2x into x plus 7 equals x square. So again simplify this. This is third one. 2x square plus 14x equals x square, right? So by transposing the term on left hand side, the sign of x square is changed, right? It is 2x square plus 14x minus x square. Now on left hand side, you can see 2x square minus x square. So we can find the difference and it will be simply x square plus 14x equals 0. Yes, it is quadratic equation because the highest power is 2. So be aware when these type of questions comes and you have to decide whether they are quadratic or not. Okay. So the simplest method is just simplify, transpose the terms and then simplify and finally find the highest power of the x. If it is 2, then quadratic. If it is anything except 2, it is not quadratic, right? Our third point is use of quadratic equations in day-to-day life. So this is one of the important point because when you solve the exercises from your textbook, you see some of the word problems where you have to make the equations then solve it. So making the equation is the important part. The equation should be balanced, then you are able to solve it. So here I am going to give some examples. First example is related to algebra, second will be from the geometry. So the question is difference of two positive numbers is 3. Okay, and difference of two positive numbers is 3 and product is 54 and the question is find the numbers. So here we just solve it. Now the question is difference of two positive numbers is 3. It means if one number is x, the another will be x minus 3, right? Because the difference is 3 and here we have to make the equation that should be balanced. So depends on the second condition. The product is 54. Product means x multiplied by x minus 3 equals 54. Now this equation is correct. Okay. And to solve it, just simplify. We have x square minus 3x and minus 54 equals 0 because we have to collect all the terms on left hand side. Now we have to factorize this by the method of middle term splitting. Okay. I tell you what is middle term splitting. It is one of the important points. X square minus 3x minus 54 equals 0. So just think about 54. Okay. We have to factorize 54 in such a way that the sum of those numbers is this minus 3, means the coefficient of x. So you should be very careful. So the factors of 54 are 18 and 3, 9 and 6, and other possibilities are there. So if you think about 18 and 3, the product is 54, all right, but the sum or difference is not 3. If we think about 9 and 6, we can find the sum as 3 by taking bigger number negative and the smaller number as positive. Okay, so product of these is 54 and the sum is 3, right? So first term and the last term can be written as it is. We are splitting the middle term. This is okay. This minus 3x we can write as minus 9x plus 6x. Okay, from these two terms, take x as common. The common means the HCF. Okay, and it is just x minus 9. From these two, 6 as common, we are left with x minus 9 equals 0. Since x minus 9 is common in the both expressions, we are left with x plus 6 equals 0. Now the product of two expressions is 0, means either one is 0. So consider one by one. If x minus 9 is 0, then x is 9, or x plus 6 is 0, then x is minus 6. But in the question it is given that the difference of two positive numbers, so x cannot be negative. Okay, we can skip this. And hence the x is equal to 9. Since two numbers are x and x minus 3. So by putting the value of x, it is 9 and 9 minus 3, that is 9 and 6. So these are the required numbers, 9 and 6. We can cross check our answer. How? See, the difference of the numbers is 3, all right? And the product of these numbers is 54. And these two values are given in the question. See, this 3 and 54. It means our answer is correct. Okay. Now, I want to take another example that is from geometry, right? So we have a rectangle. I just need to draw a rectangle, just a rough diagram. Okay. The question is, okay, first I write the question. The question is, the length of a rectangle is 2 more than 3 times the breadth. Okay, the breadth. If the area is 33 square units, find the dimensions. Okay, so the dimensions of the rectangle means just length and breadth. So we need to find the length and breadth according to the given condition. So it is one of the important questions. Now, for the convenience, I need to draw the rectangle. If you don't draw, it's all right. Okay, this is a rectangle. Okay, it is not actually rectangle properly. All the angles are right angles. This is rectangle. So the given conditions are, the length of the rectangle is 2 more than 3 times the breadth. So we assume that the breadth is x and the length is 2 more. 2 more means right plus 2. And 3 times, 3 times means 3x. So here it is the length. Second condition is, the area is 33. As you know, the area of a rectangle is just length into breadth. So area will be 33 is equal to length into breadth. Okay, we just multiply. Now, 33 equals 3x square plus 2x. After simplifying, we get 3x square plus 2x minus 33 equals 0. Collecting all the terms on left hand side and 0 will be on right hand side. So this is the equation. Now multiply 33 by 3. Okay. Remember always that multiply the constant term with the coefficient of x square. And you might be thinking that in the previous example, we didn't perform any multiplication. But see, in that question, the coefficient of x square was 1 already. Okay, here we can consider 1. So this 54 multiplied by 1 is 54 by default. So no need to think about the 1 if the coefficient is 1. We can consider the constant term only when the coefficient of x square is 1, right? But if there is something other than 1, we need to multiply. So it is 33 3 ja. Okay, so we have 33 3 ja. 99. Now we have to factorize 99 in such a way that the sum or difference of those numbers is 2. That is the coefficient of x, right? So think about those numbers. We have 11, 9, ja, 99. Simply. And you can see that the difference of these is 2. This is plus 2. The difference is plus 2 means 11 will be positive and 9 will be negative. And you can write 11x minus 9x instead of 2x. That's why this method is called middle term splitting, because we are just splitting the middle term, right? So first and last term will be as it is, and we are just splitting this, and we can write as 11x minus 9x. Next, what to do? Take a common from these two. We have 3 only, x square. Okay, we have x, not 3, because 3 cannot divide 11. So the common is x. We have 3x plus 11 and minus 3. we have 3x plus 11 equals 0. Again, 3x plus 11 is common. We are left with x minus 3. Okay. You can see the product of these expressions is 0, means either one is 0. So consider these one by one. 3x plus 11 equals 0. It means 3x is equal to minus 11. X is equal to minus 11 upon 3. Or x minus 3 is 0. Then x is equal to 0 plus 3. And x is 3. Now we have two values of x. And which is possible? This one is the possible value of x, and negative value is not possible. Why? Because the length or breadth cannot be negative, because these are the length, and length of any shape cannot be negative. So we can consider x 3. Now we can find the length and the breadth. Okay. So here I come to the diagram. As you can see, we have found x equal to 3. That is the breadth. What about the length? See, this is the length. Just put the value of x. 3 multiplied by 3 plus 2, that is 9 plus 2, 11. Okay, this is 11. So the breadth is 3 units and the length is 11 units. Now we should cross check the answer. So here I use this page as a reference. Okay, in this part the condition is the area is 33 square units. You can see that the area is just length into breadth. Okay, so length into breadth is equal to 33. That is given in the question. First condition is satisfied. And another condition is that the length is 2 more than 3 times the breadth. You can see that the breadth is 3 and there is 2 times. Okay, so we say 2 more than 3 times the breadth, and it is just equal to 2 plus 9, that is equal to 11. Now it is also satisfied. It means our answer is correct. Okay, so I have given two examples, one from the algebra, another from geometry. I think these are sufficient and will help you to understand the topic better.